Hi guys, welcome to another video here with me at The Aspiring Home Cook. Today we're going to look at making beautiful, fluffy, light, delicious blueberry pancakes. These pancakes come together in a few minutes, so you can whip them up fresh on the morning that you'd like to enjoy them. You just need a handful of pantry staples and you're good to go. So let's go ahead and take a look at the recipe. So to make your super fluffy, delicious blueberry pancakes, here's what you're going to need. 1 cup of flour. This is just regular all-purpose flour. I've got in here 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. 1.5 tablespoons of sugar. This is 2 tablespoons of butter that I've melted and brought back down to room temperature. You've got 1 egg. 1.5 cup of buttermilk. Now your buttermilk is what I find makes the biggest difference in making your pancakes nice and fluffy. The recipe will work with milk if you don't have buttermilk on hand, but I find that the buttermilk makes a big difference to the flavor as well as lightness of the pancake. You're going to need 1 egg. If you've got fresh blueberries, nothing like that. I've got some on hand, so I'm going to add some into the pancakes, and just a tiny pinch of salt. I've used salted butter over here, which is why I've dropped that down. If you're using unsalted butter, you could go up to maybe 1/4 teaspoon of salt, or add salt to taste. That's all that you're going to need to make your pancakes from scratch. In addition to those ingredients, you're going to need a little vanilla bean paste or vanilla extract and a tiny touch of oil to get your pan started. Now, making your pancakes is super simple. We're going to assemble 2 lots of ingredients, the dry ingredients and the wet ingredients. Let's start off with the dry. All you're going to need for this recipe is a big mixing bowl, your whisk. A whisk will make your life so much more easier when it comes to putting together your batter. So into that bowl goes your all-purpose flour, salt, your baking powder and your baking soda, and your sugar. And you're going to just gently whisk that together just to make sure everything is mixed through. And you're going to set this bowl aside just for a few moments while we work with our wet ingredients. Okay, so I've got my buttermilk in here. To the buttermilk, I'm going to add my vanilla. 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract is enough. You're going to pop in your melted butter. This is the ingredient that will actually prevent the batter from sticking to your pan. And you're going to crack in 1 egg. I'm going to get my whisk and beat all this together till it's all evenly incorporated. It doesn't take much, just a gentle whisk. You're just looking for the egg to break up and mix through all of the other ingredients really well. And that's it. Now for the last step of your batter, you've got your dry ingredients. Into the dry ingredients go your wet ingredients. Just gonna pour that all in. And then using my whisk, I'm just going to mix everything thoroughly. You're going to whisk this up till no lumps remain. And that took me about 30 seconds. And guys, this is how simple it is to make your batter from scratch. Once you've tried homemade pancakes with a homemade batter, you'll never go to those store-bought ready batters ever again. It has possibly taken me longer to explain this to you than it would take you to actually put everything together. And lastly, you're just going to fold in some blueberries. Just a gentle mix is enough. As far as the blueberries go, you can use as much or as little as you'd like. Now that our batter is ready, let's go onto the stovetop and start cooking off these pancakes. Once your pan has heated, I just use a light spray of cooking oil to get the whole process started. I find that after that, I oftentimes don't even need to keep spraying the pan. But if you feel like you need to do that, then just a tiny bit of oil should do just fine. So just a light spray of cooking oil, and I'm going to ladle over, just using a large spoon, some of this pancake batter. I'm just going to spread that out into what resembles somewhat of a circle. Again, you can make these pancakes as large or as small as you'd like. And you're just going to leave it there and let that cook off. Now, the minute you see bubbles appearing on the surface, you know that your pancake has started to cook off. Now, my husband and I, we really like our pancakes lightly browned on the edges. So on the fried sides, you may notice that these are a little more brown than you like. If you prefer your pancakes finished off to be a little less brown, more blonde, by all means, you can flip them earlier. We're just going to take a tiny peek now. So using a spatula, I'm going to just lift and make sure that it's ready to flip. The pancake has puffed up. Slowly and carefully, you're going to lift and flip. And you're going to let it continue cooking till it's done. It just takes less than a minute on each side to cook through. And they're very delicate, so handle them carefully. I'm just going to take it off the pan and place it on a plate. That's the other side, just for you to have a look at. And we're going to continue with the rest of the pancake batter. And that's it, guys. Your blueberry pancakes are ready. How quick and how simple was that? Let's have a look at these pancakes now. So I've just got a couple of them here. This is how nice and soft and fluffy they become. These pancakes are best enjoyed while they're nice and warm. They will deflate just a tiny bit as they cool down, but they'll still be equally delicious. Now you can enjoy these as they are. What I like to do is just drizzle a little maple syrup over the top. Again, as much or as little as you'd like. And dig in. That's it. I'm just going to show you what they look like. Nice, light, fluffy. You've got blueberries in there with almost every bite. And the blueberries will be ever so slightly cooked and a little jammy and altogether just delicious. Blueberry pancakes are one of my favorite special breakfast treats. I hope you enjoyed today's video, guys. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel below. Feel free to share this video with family and friends who you think might enjoy this recipe. Thank you so much for watching today, guys, and I'm going to see you really soon with another delicious recipe. So till then, take care. Bye.